Hello, Scorpio. Elsie here to do a reading for you, my friends. It is for the week ahead. How are you, Scorpio? Thank you so much for clicking here. If you are brand new, hot off the press for Ten of Cups Tarot, welcome. I hope you'll be in the comments. We like to be there sometimes. Some of us do. I hope that if you're cross-watching, you'll let me know that. And thank you for your thumbs up and the way that you're helping this community grow, this Scorpio community. We need it. Feminines and masculines, where you at? All right, here we go. Let's talk about it. We're going to throw some oracles, throw some tarot. We'll find out what's coming up for the week ahead, please, for Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Jupiter. What's coming up for Scorpio? We do have intuition. Your intuition's on high with something here. Scorpio, and of course, number two means that this is the card of the High Priestess. A lot of you are High Priestesses. I think probably all of you are, to be honest. Maybe some of you aren't as aware of it, but all of you do have psychic energy. You are the psychic giant of the zodiac. You certainly are. Let's take a look here. We have destiny, which is the wheel, y'all. Okay, so your gut is telling you that something really good is coming, Scorpio. Something, it's destined, right? Something is fated or destined to move forward here. And then we have the waiting game. I want to say be patient. I mean, you are one of the most patient, right? You will wait as long as you have to wait in order to get what you want, because you're the one who is strategically planning your next move. You're not going to, unless you have some crazy fire in your chart somewhere, a lot of it. Maybe Scorpio is your only water sign and the rest is fire. Who knows? I feel like you're waiting, but I don't think you're going to wait forever, honestly, because the Wheel of Fortune is here and so is the card of moving on. This to me is the Six of Swords. And then, of course, number 10 is the Wheel of Fortune. So I don't think you're going to wait forever. I think we've got two cards. Number two, I feel like you're in this very balanced energy of if it happens, it happens, but it better hurry up, because if it doesn't, I'm on my way. I'm not going to spend time looking out the window forlornly waiting for somebody to show up. We've got spiritual strength, and that's you, right? It's what you've got. You've got spiritual strength, I feel. Although this is Virgo energy, spiritual strength, the card number nine is the Hermit energy. It feels like maybe you've been spending time alone, possibly, but it is time for you to move on. And we do have the waiting game. I feel like what you're waiting for is for things to get better or things to move forward. It feels like you already know this is coming. I want to say for some of you, you already know that there is something good coming here. Let's take a look at some tarot. And then we will look at the Sign of the Times Oracle. And that's going to be for, this is going to be for the week ahead, my friends. This is going to be a little bit further to that. So as we read this, this is going to cover, for those of you who are interested, going to cover, you know, sort of the Valentine's energy as well, getting around the 14th. Tell me about intuition, please, as it pertains to Scorpio. What's Scorpio got this intuition on high for? I feel like you know something good is coming here. I think you feel it, but you can't see it. It's like you're excited about something and you don't know what that is. Tell me about intuition, please. We have the Eight of Cups. And so it does feel like you are about to walk away from something here. So I don't know if it's a job or a friendship or a loveship. Take it as it resonates. It's all about you. So I'm just going to read what's on the cards here and you can figure out if it's your energy or not. The Eight of Cups tells me that your intuition is telling me that you need to pull away from something emotionally. You need to cut the string here. You need to cut the string and you need to move forward. And I feel like you know that you must do this because it is destiny. And the Wheel of Fortune is here. You know, the Wheel of Fortune is also about really, it's a lot of change, right? And you, I feel like when you decide to pull away out of this vibration from the past here, that you are making great change here. It does feel, I want to say that you're walking slow toward the finish line because you're hoping someone is going to catch up to you or something is going to catch up to you, whatever it is. Tell me about this destiny here. There is a bunch of change that's about to come to you in the middle of next week. Something is about to change. Tell me what that is. It's sort of a destined change here. We do have the King of Wands. So you are stepping away. You're stepping forward. Now, the King of Wands never does anything without inspiration, right? This is divine inspiration that the King of Wands gets in order to move forward. And if it's not something that is putting fire in the belly or fire around the heart, this person is not going to move forward. They need to be inspired to move forward. So I feel like the Wheel of Fortune is bringing that for you. It's setting a fire in your gut, telling you it's time to go forward. There's more out there. I need to go out there and find what it is that is for me. But it almost feels like you're dragging your heels a little bit because you're hoping that maybe if you go slow, that you'll feel a little braver as you move forward here. But I mean, the waiting game is you, right? You're not one, unless you got a lot of crazy fire in your chart, you're not the one who's just going to jump in head first. You're going to observe. You're going to observe from a distance. You're going to plot and you're going to move towards the goal slowly. You're going to take in all the information before you decide to make a decision. Tell me why we've got the waiting game. We've got the Three of Cups. Oh, very interesting. So either you're waiting to see what's going to happen here, if you're inspired to call someone and ask them out, possibly. But I feel like things are about to turn a corner, I want to say for you. The waiting game is the Three of Cups. It feels like you're about to become more social. That there's some sort of an exciting social thing coming up, and maybe you don't give your answer right away. Maybe you're waiting to see who's going to be there. Where is it going to be? Do I really want to go that far across the city to be at this place here? But I do feel like you are making some sort of a decision. We do have the Three of Pentacles here, which is a partnership. It's a collaboration and cooperation. So it feels like with this particular one, this excitement here, that you're waiting to see who's going to arrive at this, you might be invited to a dinner or somebody's house, or, hey, let's go horseback riding or bowling, or somebody's going to invite you somewhere. And I think that you have to be inspired. You have to really want to do it. So I think you're going to play the waiting game. You're going to sort of pull back, look at all the details, make sure you know who's going to be there and how you're going to have to act while you're there. And, let's find out what's coming up. This is the week ahead, and this is going to be a little bit further to that. So we're getting into about the third week of February with these Sign of the Times Oracle. Tell me what's coming up closer to the end of the month here for Scorpio, please. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Jupiter. Tell me about Scorpio. We have Recycle, Recover, and Hello Again. Okay, so this makes more sense. I think that possibly you might know somebody who's going to be at this party, and that's why you're holding back, because you know that this is going to be a go around again, that it's like a recycled relationship, a recycled friendship. You're not sure if you want to get together with this person or this group of people because you're kind of in recovery, right? And we've got card number 21, which is a 3. This is a 3. So is this. We've got 3, 3, 3, right? So we've got the energy of being on the right path. It is an abundant path, I feel. And I also feel like this is an opportunity for you to grow, like this is a new journey. And I think you're being careful about it. We do have action. So there it is. I feel like you do eventually take action. We've got card number 34, which is a 7. Sevens for me are all about heaven and divine things and the universe looking out for you, having your back. You've got some pretty heavy hitting energies here coming up in the week ahead and a little bit further to that. I want to say that there is somebody who is also invited to this, or you want to know, or you're doing your work, your detective work to find out who else is going to be at this gathering, because I feel like that's going to play a big decision into whether you go or not, because maybe you're just not into this. Maybe you're just not into recycling, or, you know, recycling friendships or relationships, or, you know, whatever that is over there. We've got stability with the anchor, and we've got wonder with the firefly, and an opportunity. So it feels like for some of you, there is going to be an opportunity coming up in February that's going to give you a bit of financial stability. For those of you who are wondering, we do have card number 16, which is the Tower, but this shows up as stability. So I want to say that whatever Tower is going to befall you, whatever Tower is coming, is a good one. You're going to wonder why the Tower is happening, why this change is here. And I feel like it's because it's bringing in some sort of a new opportunity here. So you have an opportunity to rekindle, recycle, recover. Hello again, it says, or you have something brand new that's coming in the future here. All right, so let's talk about the intuition. Because it feels like your gut is telling you that you need to leave something in the past, that you need to pull away emotionally from something here. Your gut is telling you to do that, that there's more behind the door than you realize. There's something really great that's shining behind the door there. Tell me about the Eight of Cups here. We have the Fool. It's a new day. It's a new thought pattern. I feel like you are pulling away emotionally from someone or something, and you need a new beginning here. I think you're going to listen to your gut. I was going to say this time, so maybe some of you aren't always listening to your gut, but it feels like you are about to listen to your gut. It's going to pay out in Pentacles. We have the Queen of Pentacles here who is emulating the Empress. So whether you are feminine or masculine, you could be the Queen of Pentacles, who is Capricorn, but also Taurus and Virgo in this general reading. This is a general reading after all. It's not going to resonate with everybody, but we do have the Queen of Pentacles here. And then we do have the Queen of Cups. Interesting. So look, I feel like you know that if you should pull away from whatever's in the past, now this could be anything. It doesn't have to be a love relationship. It could be anything. But remember, these readings, Scorpio, are your perception. I'm bringing in the energies, but I don't know what's going on in your life. So it's your perception of what's going on. And what I think is going on here is that somebody's pulling away from an energy from the past. It's going to cause a new beginning, which is going to give you stability. And the Queen of Cups is here, which is giving you a little more compassion for yourself, I think. Maybe the reason you're pulling away from whatever was back there is because you do have compassion for yourself now. Your gut is telling you have compassion and get yourself stabilized in your 3D world. You need to get solid and grounded and make sure that you're moving slow. We do have a tower coming up here. What's after the tower? Six of Swords, moving on. So this is a permanent change. You don't feel it right now, but I feel as you pull out of an old vibration that the tower is going to allow you to move forward here and you will stay out of that vibration. But first, as you're pulling out of this vibration, please know that you are coming to a place where you are taking a leap of faith into your 3D world, focusing on you, focusing on work, focusing on your money, focusing on all the things that you need to focus on about you. And while you do that, we have someone here who is taking care of the self, the one who's compassionate. I'm no longer going to smack talk myself. I'm not going to tell myself I got to go back there. Tell me about the King of Wands here and the Destiny card. Tell me about the Wheel of Fortune and the King of Wands. We have the Hierophant. This is a lesson learned here. I feel as though when this when these changes come up, they are coming up for the purpose of teaching you something. The Hierophant is, and I want to say too, is that the Hierophant is someone who is being held to a higher standard, and you are the spiritual giant of the zodiac, right? You are being held to a higher standard because you've been given these tools, these spiritual tools to help guide you through your life. I want to say with the Six of Cups and the King of Pentacles, it feels like with the King of Pentacles, first of all, your money's going to be off the chain. It feels like you are coming into a very prosperous time in your 3D world. Now that could mean anything to a lot of you. It could mean maybe you leave a job back here. Maybe that's the vibration you're pulling out of something that was not really necessarily working out for you. You are about to, if you've been let go of a job or if you've pulled away from a job, I feel like your money is about to go great. You are about to get stable and sturdy and balanced and have more than you need. Opportunities come to the king. The king does not have to go out and look for opportunities. So I feel with the Wheel of Fortune here that your money, your opportunities, your stability, everything is about to take a turn for the better, moving into a fortunate position here. The Hierophant energy, of course, is Taurus. We do have the King of Pentacles, who is Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Now, I'm just going to say, we do have the Queen of Pentacles and the King of Pentacles. So I don't know if maybe a Queen of Pentacles or a Queen of Cups is maybe somebody that some of you could be pulling away from. The Queen of Pentacles, of course, being Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Scorpio, Pisces, or Cancer. We do have the King and the Queen of Pentacles here. So, and the King looking into the past, it feels like that somebody has history with either the Queen of Cups or the Queen of Pentacles. And it could be that you need to begin again and pull away from somebody who's in the past here, because you do have a lot of history with them. But the universe is telling you, look, you have to stop looking back there. It's time for you to stop looking at, oh, maybe I should still be back there. We have a lot of nostalgia. We have a lot of time spent together. It doesn't matter. You know, what matters is that you learn the lesson about what was in the past. And yeah, you do have a lot of nostalgia, but did you learn anything? Did you learn anything from what happened back there? And I think that you do. You're ready to learn. I think you're ready to step forward with the Wheel of Fortune and finally break the chains of whatever is back here. Because I really think that whatever's back here, you're pulling out of it for a particular reason. And I think it was because it was holding you back. So I do feel that you are coming into some really great stability here in your finances, for sure. But I want to say that whatever is in the past is in the past. And the lessons that you've had in the past with this nostalgia card here, I feel like it's for a reason. it's in the past for a reason here. Tell me about the waiting game. So it feels like you are being kind of apprehensive or holding back, possibly with the Three of Cups here. You know that there's a celebration. You know something great is going on. You're going to be invited somewhere. You're maybe going to get a call and say, hey, come out with us to wherever it is. But I feel like you're playing the waiting game because I think you want to know using your two, right? Using the intuition to figure out what's going on here. So you're going to try and get all the details. You're just going to say, look, just be straight with me. Who's on the guest list? Who's going to be there, right? The Seven of Swords is like you demanding honesty and truth. And something is coming to the surface that you didn't think would come to the surface. You don't want any surprises at this point. You're not good with surprises, right? You would rather have all the details. So I think that you're just going to be honest with the person who invites you out. Seven of Swords in the reverse. Tell me everything. Give me clarity. Tell me what's going on. Don't surprise me with anybody showing up here. We've got the Two of Wands, which tells me that this is going to be quite an adventure. And I feel like you're kind of stuck at the Two of Wands here. You need to make a decision. The King of Wands would make the decision. I feel like you're going to have to make a decision. That's why the King of Wands has shown up here. With the Two of Wands, it's about adventure. I need to make a decision. Do I go that way or do I go this way? Do I want the adventure? Do I want to expand in my life? But I need to know who's going to be there. Tell me about this. We've got the Nine of Wands because you don't want to go through this again. I feel like you don't want to go through that again. You don't want to, you're already exhausted. You've been working really hard to pull yourself out of an old vibration and you don't want to go back there. You are the wounded warrior. I think other people have hurt you, whether it's with words or actions, and it feels like some, it could be a little bit of both. But I feel like you're being asked to step forward and maybe test your resolve. With the Nine of Wands, the reason that you're holding back with the waiting game here is because you are the wounded warrior. You're exhausted from, you know, I feel like this get-together could mean that people are trying to set you up with someone or getting you to meet someone. You know, maybe it's friends who are getting that person in and then calling you in, and you're just not about it, I feel. Tell me more about this waiting game. And are you going to go to this celebration here? Seven of Wands, feeling a little defensive. Three of Wands, yeah, I think you're going to go. I think you've done enough work on yourself, and I think you're going to go. The Eight of Pentacles is telling me that you've been working on yourself for quite some time. The self-mastery is here, but also that maybe you're willing to work on whatever the person who is going to be invited with, you know, that's being invited purposefully because you're going to be there. I feel like you're ready and open to work on it. It's like it's time now, right? The Three of Wands is in the reverse. Maybe you're feeling a little defensive as you move forward here, but we do have the Three of Wands, and three and seven is 10. So I feel like you're going to be able to drop your burdens with somebody here. Tell me why the waiting game. So what you don't want is you don't want it to end up in some sort of situation where you're going to be stuck thinking about this person over and over and over again. And that's why you are in the waiting game energy. You're trying to gain wisdom over the situation. The Seven of Swords showing up in the reverse is important information. I feel like you need to get more details, all the details, just so you're not walking into something that you're not expecting. The Ace of Pentacles is here, and it tells me that maybe you've decided that it's time to open a new path, that it is time for you to maybe look at whatever else is out there, right? Whatever else is out there. So I think that for most of you, you are going to say yes, because I feel like you're feeling pretty confident about the way that you've been working hard on the self, and that maybe it is time to go. Maybe it is time to drop some burdens. So no matter who shows up, maybe I'll have some fun and it's time to drop some burdens. Tell me about recycle, recover, hello again, and action. Tell me about this. We have the Six of Wands, we have the Four of Cups, and the Chariot. I want to say that the person that is at this gathering or get-together here, I think is somebody who gives you, who gives you a lot of attention. Maybe that's a sign that it's true. That came on from nowhere. Okay, so we do have the Six of Wands. I feel like it almost feels like the person who I think is purposefully at this get-together here, and I think you're going to know before you go because you're going to ask a lot of questions. I think this person wants to give you a lot of their a lot of attention here. I feel that they're very attracted to you. They want to give you a lot of attention, but I think you're going to get a lot of attention from a lot of other people too. So not just from this person that you already know, who you've already been in a partnership with, like you know them through friends of friends. I don't mean you've dated them. So I feel like you're going to get a lot of attention at this party, and I feel like you're going to decide to go. I feel like you think it's a good opportunity to take action here. We do have the Four of Cups here. So I feel like whatever information you take away from the gathering is going to follow you into like the third week of February. And so it feels like you're somebody offers you a cup at this gathering. So I feel like they offer you a cup. Look, we have the Three of Cups here, and I'm talking about the Three of Cups situation. I feel like somebody here offers you a cup or asks you to go out or can I have your number, and you just shelf them. You shelf them for now because you're not really sure what it is that you want to do. I think you are going to move forward here though, but not showing them all of your feelings on the surface. I feel like probably in the third week of February, if you are looking at this as a love reading, that some of you are going to be moving forward with the person that you meet at this gathering. For others of you, if this is not a love reading for you, I do feel that that you are breaking out of this energy of going back round, because it says hello again. It feels like you keep revisiting something in the mind, and I feel like you've decided to shelf that you're not going to think about it anymore. It's time to move off into the future where there is victory. Bottom of the deck is Judgment card. We have the Nine of Swords. So it does feel like for some of you, you're going to meet some sort of a romantic interest, possibly, or there is a decision, a big decision that you have to make about the lovers here, something that is going to change the trajectory of your life. Bottom of the deck, we have Five of Wands. There's a lot of internal struggle. You don't know what to do. Dragging your heels, not really sure. You're going to have to think it out. I'm going to leave it here for now. Thank you, Scorpio, for watching. I do appreciate you. I'll be back because I'm always back. And here I go. See you guys later. Bye-bye.